Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Learn IT. Today we will be having another interesting session, that is business rules. So if you are new to the channel, please like, share and subscribe to my channel Learn IT. Please watch my videos till the end for complete information. So let's proceed and see what is business rules. What is a business rule? It is a type of JavaScript that runs when a table is queried, when a record is inserted, updated, deleted or displayed. It can be used to change values in fields when any certain conditions are met. It executes on server side, which usually is faster. So let's move further and see how our business rule executes. So for executing our business rule, it requires what table it will be executed. Here you can see we have defined the table as a problem, and when it execute, like when to run. So we can run on insert, update, delete or query. So right now it is selected as update. So this is just an example, like we can select when to run. All right, then we can see further how it triggers or how we can add the conditions under when to run. So we can see, we can define some criteria for execution of business rule logic, and we can select on what basis we have to execute this business rule. Suppose there is a problem, filter conditions, where we can see problem state is one of resolved or closed, and there is one more conditions like role. We can define the role on which this business rule will be executing. Alright, then we can move further and see how business rule actually executes. So first, the business rule user will be querying the database or any table. So the query which will be done, it is a query business rule, it will be running when we are querying any table in the database. So that's why it will fetch before the database provides us the data. And when the database query is done, so after that display business rule runs whenever we get some data from server side. So that means we are displaying the data from database. And then after the form submission, we can see there is a before business rule. So it runs after form submission and before database update. So that is before business rule. And we can see when a database update happens, after that we run after business rules, and after we run async business rule. So we will see in detail how these types of business rule executes actually, and I will tell you how this works. So let's move ahead and see how these types of business rule actually runs. So we can see when business rule runs on before query, whenever we are requesting any data from the database. So it will be executing when a query is sent to the database. So it will be displayed all the data, whatever we are requesting from the database. Suppose we have to request same kind of incident for particular location, or like we can see the example, we can prevent users from one location seeing CIs from another. So this could be the one example, and there could be many more. So before query, business rule queries the database. So this is all about before query, and let's move further and see how display rule works. So display rule will work after the data is read from the database and before the form is presented to the user. So yeah, because we can see if we are fetching any data from server side, so we can get those data under before query rules. And primary purpose is to populate the g_scratchpad global object, which will be used inside onload client script to fetch the database values or server side values, whatever we are requesting from client side to be executed while we are getting the data from the database. Alright, so it will execute and populates the g_scratchpad object using display business rule. And when the form submission happens, so we have before rules, so we can see how it executes. So before business rule executes after the form submission and before the record is updated in the database. Suppose we have to populate closed by with the name of currently logged in user whenever we are closing any ticket or incident. So we can populate this closed by with the name. So here we have seen example like how we can use our before query business rule. So we can see after business rule how it executes. So let's see how after business rule runs. So it executes after form submission and when the record is updated in the database. So there is an example like we can cascade changes made to the approval field of a service catalog request to the requested items attached to that request. So whatever changes has been done as part of request approval field, so same will be added on relevant requested items. So this executes under after business rule. So let's see how async business rule runs. So it executes after records are inserted, modified or queried. So it will run asynchronously as scheduled jobs. So example, we can see we can notify subscribers when CIs are affected by an incident or any SLA calculations. And there can be many more calculations, that is like if suppose there are more complex calculations happening on server execution, then at that point of time we can use async business rules so that our existing work is not impacted on the current form. Alright, so this is all about execution of async business rule. So let's move further and see what business rule trigger actions does. So we can see we are having a action tab where we can see what to execute and what things we can do here. So suppose we can set the field values and we can set the message if any message has to be displayed on certain records. So script is not required, we can just set the message here, and as well as we can set the value without writing any script using set values options here. Alright, so let's move and see what we can do under advanced tab. So advanced tab is activated whenever we have to write any complex conditions or any action scripts which has to be written. So we can use this advanced conditions checkbox and then we can define certain conditions and script here and we can execute whatever is required as part of certain project. Alright, so let's move further and see what is server-side global variables and what data can you see in business rules. So we can see like local variables declared in a script and we can see predefined server-side global variables like current, previous, g underscore scratchpad. Display business rules only works in conjunction with a client-side script. So you can see below how g scratchpad is used. And we can see how global variables dot walking works. So it allows direct access to fields for related records like reference records. Suppose we have a field caller in incident table. So we can get the reference, like you can see here current.caller id.department.name. So we can fetch the caller department name on current table using global variables. So as an example, you can see object dot reference object name dot field of interest. So this is the syntax and here is the example current dot caller id dot department dot name. So we can see here, so how it works, we can see incident table is provided here and the caller id, we have sysid and it is dot walking to this particular sysid and it is again dot walking to the name which is sales. So we can get the name of current department name of current caller of incident. So this is the way how it works as a dot walking in server side script. So we can see global variables automatically inserting the dot walking path whenever we write any script. So you can see in below example, we can see many dot walking features that can be utilized under business rules, so that it's very easier to find out what dot walking can be possible on certain forms. So you can see here, and this is automatically inserted whenever we select any table on this business rule. So according to that, whatever fields are available to do dot walking, so we can use it here. So let's move further and see how we can debug our business rules. So for debugging our business rule, we have certain methods like glide system logging methods, debug business rules module, script debugger, script tracer, console debugger, right? So we have multiple ServiceNow server side debugging tools, so we can use those. And JavaScript debugger is try-catch, which is like a very popular on in terms of JavaScript, but in ServiceNow we can use these methods, which is very easy to find like where our business rule is stuck and what it is doing. So let's move further and see what are all those glide system logging methods. So we can see how we can send the debugging information to the system log. So suppose we can use gs.info, which is used for informational events such as message that will be displayed whenever we are performing certain things. And gs.log, this always logs a message when it is used in a global scope. So gs.error, it is used for critical errors that are coming while execution. So gs.warning is used for logging when there might be some issue. And gs.debug, it will occur in a debug mode or when a session debug for that application is enabled. So debugging will start on that particular business rule. And we can see how we can display the debugging information on our form where we are executing our business rule. So we have gs.addInfoMessage, gs.addErrorMessage, and gs.some method name, like whatever is available for our use in terms of business rule, and we can use those as well. So whatever methods are available, we can use under business rule to send some information to the form. So we can see like how debugging works here. So debugging server side JavaScript, so we can see we have our select script debugger under business rule scripting section. So you can see this, we can click on this and it will open our another browser window along with the script tracer, and we can see the session log as well when we click on those. And as well as we can click on system diagnostics, and we can click on script debugger here on the navigator, and we can do it from filter navigator as well. So both ways we can do our script debugging. So for business rule demo, there will be another video coming soon, so stay tuned for that. Please provide your comment if you have any questions, doubts or queries related to this session. For more information, please visit description section under this video. Thanks for hearing me out. Stay tuned for more videos. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel LearnIT.